Hey, I'm back, guys. What's going on? Shalom, shalom, shalom. Peace and blessings. Let's get into it. Let's get into it, folk. Let's get into it, my guys, my ladies and gents. Whew. We all know how it feels, you know. I'm trying to make the best out of, situations that seem like, you know. Sometimes they can feel unfair. That's one thing I can say. One year, everything's going to be going splendid. The next thing you know, it seems like life is just like flipping upside down on you. Sometimes it can just really leave you starstruck on how things can turn from going normal to doing twists and turns in life. But trust me, if you're not the only one that's going through it, and nor will you be the last, nor will I be the last. And, you know, just like in the book of Job, he was a child of God. He was a believer in Christ. And, you know, his life got flipped upside down. So just know the enemy's doing that to a lot of people in this world. But, Job was faithful to God through it all. Same way how God wants us to be faithful. And, of course, when you're a new believer, you know, it's like you need training. So, of course, you're going to be overwhelmed easily. You are going to be, you know, get stressed easily. You're going to be tempted more easier than, you know, a person that has been dealing with, you know, spiritual battles longer than you. You know, just know God's grace is unmatched. We cannot put it in a box. We cannot comprehend His grace, you know, because His grace is past all of our understanding. Because, you know, He knows all of our strengths, you know. If it wasn't for His grace, we wouldn't be here, you know, because we all make mistakes. We all sin every day. We all make wrong decisions, you know, and God knows that, you know, He knows through our mistakes, we open ourselves up to be, you know, to be manipulated or, you know, destroyed even. But, you know, God is just so merciful in how much He protects us. And He doesn't give the, He doesn't let the desires of the wicked or these demons to do what they, you know, what they are here to do. You know, he'll let them do to an extent just to get His, you know, so you can be pushed into your purpose, so you can, you know, realize, you know, the pitfalls of certain decisions when we're making certain choices and things like that. So, you know, the state that this world is in, you know, it just seems a lot of backwardness. It's a lot of rebellious tendencies being carried out, and a lot of blasphemy going on. You know, God already said in the last days the son of perdition will be exalting themselves against, you know, God, you know, exalting themselves like they are God, above God. You know, and they're gonna try to, you know, demand, you know, men of power are gonna try to take control of, like, people who can, you know, especially people who are poor. So just know, and God said that God is going to use the same poor people to tread down the cities of the high and lofty ones. So just know God is strategic and everything. You know, we all know the saying, things had to get worse before they get better. And you see things are, seems very dark, but through God wants us to, He wants us to lean on Him at all times, despite what it looks like, despite what's coming your way, despite the battle. You know, it's like an unending fight, you know, with Satan. You know, he's here to wear us out on all sides. He wants to, you know, wear you out in your finances. He wants to wear you out in your mind. He wants to wear you out spiritually. He wants to wear you out physically. He wants to wear you out in every way he can. You know, he's damned to eternity, to hell. So, you know, he's just doing any and everything to, you know, bring as many people as with him. It makes total sense. You know, when you understand that, it just makes it it makes it more easier to, you know, withstand, you know, the wiles. God said, put on the whole armor of God. Ephesians 6, he said, finally, my brother, be strong in the Lord and the power of his might. You know, for we do not wrestle against flesh and blood, but against principalities, powers, against rulers of darkness, especially wickedness in high places, you know. So stand standing therefore, put on the whole armor of God, so that you may withstand the wiles of the devil. So we're all withstanding the wiles of the wicked. You know, it's just like a bulldog, relentless, you know, seeking who he may devour. So, you know, we got to be vigilant and sober-minded. You know, the enemy has many ways to try to pull you right back down, you know. And it even uses our own mind to get to us, you know. You know, you got a lot of people that's holding on to grudges, holding on to regret, holding on to past hurt, holding on to past resentment because of what they, you know, that girlfriend did, or what that, you know, or what those old friends did to them, how they, you know, they betrayed them and then talked bad about them to a whole bunch of people. Now people looked at you funny. And just remember, Satan is an accuser of the brethren. You know, he wants to slander, he wants to mock. And just know the children of God go through all these things, persecutions. God already said, blessed are those when men persecute you, when men mock you, when men say all men of evil against you. For great is your reward in heaven. And I believe that's in, you go to Mark. I'm going to just go there before I really start getting to the prayers that I want to get into. Because this, you know, the more wisdom that we can obtain about his word, you know, the more easier and the more equipped we'll be. Because God, man, because the enemy operates off ignorance. And we know more about the truth. You know, the enemy can't lie to you as much. But the enemy just wants to lie to you all day. Get you to jump off the ledge through lies. He wants you to give up through lies. He wants you to submit through lies to him. He wants you to give up on God through lies. He wants to lie to us and say, God is not with you anymore. God has truly deserted you. You're done. So, Mark. Let's see one thing. I might be able to find it. And it might be in Matthew. Let's try Matthew. This is about the blessing. Blessed are those, you know, blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy. I just want to get one of the promises in. You might be able to find it before me. And I should really know this scripture, that's the same. Let me see. It might be Matthew 5. Let me see. Yep, it is Matthew 5. So God said, blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. So God is saying, blessed are the poor, you know. You're poor in spirit, you're down, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they that mourn. So the children of God are mourning. He said, for they shall be comforted. The Lord shall comfort you. So you ask God, Lord, release the spirit of comfort onto me. God already said, even though you walk through the shadows of the valley of death, Psalm 23. Even though you walk through the shadows of the valley of death, you shall fear no evil, for thou art with you. He shall comfort thee. Your rod and your staff, they comfort you. So he will comfort you. He will comfort his children. You know, when you're fresh and, you know, when you're doing that first, when you first start your journey with God, of course, it's harder in the beginning to deal with things that the enemy does to you, because you're fresh. It's like a baby. It's like starting a new, it's like learning how to play football. You know, at first it's hard. It's overwhelming. They're training. You know, when a coach push you through the, you know, football practice, when you first start, you don't have great conditioning. You don't have as much as capacity, your endurance as much as, you know, long. So, of course, when you first start, you're easily worn out, you're easily discomforted, you're easily deceived. So, you know, the more you stay in God, then he'll increase your discernmentship, to see through things more, to be able to see through situations before they even, you know, you'll be able to see things happen before they happen. You'll be able to read the spirit on people before even talking to them. Before they don't even have to speak out of their mouth, you can see the spirit on a person. You'll be able to hear the voice of God about a person. Whether should I continue to date this person, or should I leave this person alone? So it's all about just increasing your discernmentship, your receptiveness, your endurance. God already said, those that trust in the name of the Lord, those that trust in the Lord, they will renew their strength, and they will mount up with eagles. They will run and not get weary. You will walk and not faint. So this whole thing, the wicked powers, the demons, they want to wear us out until you faint. God said not to let y'all be faint. So that's the whole thing. It says, blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. So the meek shall inherit the earth. So blessed are they which do hunger and thirst. You know, if you God said, you're blessed when you hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they shall be filled. He will fill you with righteousness. It said, "Bless all the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy." So that's why it's so important to have be merciful, because God will bless you. In the time that you need mercy, He will be merciful unto you. It said, this scripture in the Bible said, if you want me to forgive you, He said, how do you expect me to forgive you if you don't forgive the person who betrayed you or a person who hurt your feelings? So you had to, forgive those who trespass against you. So you ask God, Lord, forgive those who trespass against me. So if you want to receive God's forgiveness, you must forgive those people who are continuously talking about you, because at the end of the day, it's deeper than flesh. It's deeper than flesh. It's a spirit. It's a power. It's a demon that's controlling him and influencing him to do those things. He can't. That person is not filled with the Spirit of God, so they are used for his destruction, to destroy and to diminish you, to tear you down, because that spirit knows you're a child of God. That spirit knows you have a child of a light. It has God light. It's inside of you. So just know. So it says, bless all the pure in heart, for they shall see God. So the pure in heart shall see God. So ask God to purify your heart. We can't do this on our own. We can't do this by self-right. It's called self-sufficiency and self-righteousness. God despises self-righteousness and self-sufficiency. So as far as self-sufficiency is leaning on your own intellect and leaning on your own strengths. So God always said, those that trust in the day with the Lord, those that trust in the Lord will renew their strength. So the person that's leaning on self-sufficiency will eventually give out versus the person that's leaning on God for that strength. So He will bless you with supernatural strength. Because this life is spiritual. The enemy knows if he can weigh you out in the spiritual, he can overwhelm you and overcome you and really get to you like they want. So it says, blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called the children of God. So be a peacemaker, he said. Blessed are they which are persecuted. So persecute you, accuse you, slander you, mock you, conspire, persecute you for righteousness. When you're righteous, for righteousness sake, you will be persecuted. Said, for there is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are ye when men shall revile you and persecute you and say all manner of evil against you falsely for his name's sake. Same way Jesus Christ was falsely accused of things he never did or never said. He just spoke the word of God, and he spoke with truth. He spoke with boldness, and the people were manipulated by demons and powers and principalities to come against him. Even to conspire against him. Says, so God has said, you're blessed when men shall revile you. It doesn't feel good. It doesn't feel good when you are persecuted. We're just gonna be realistic about it. That's it. And shall say, oh man, of evil against you, falsely, for my sake. Rejoice and be exceeding glad. So the Lord said, rejoice. Father and Spirit of rejoice. Somehow, somewhere. Say, be exceeding glad, for great is your reward in heaven. For so persecuted the prophets. So the prophets were even persecuted. They were persecuted just by speaking the word of God to the lost. Just remember, God is not, he didn't come, when he shed his blood on the cross, he didn't come to save those that were holier than thou and righteous. He came for those that were sin, living a sinful life, those who, were in darkness. So the same thing he's going to do again. He's going to deliver his children that are in pain, affliction, going through oppression, all type of manner of wickedness that's being done to the children of God. And it says, blessed are you when men shall, so rejoice and be exceeding glad. So be exceeding glad, for great is your reward. So your reward will be great in heaven. So for so persecuted they the prophets which were before you. Ye are the salt of the earth. So we are the salt of the earth. The Lord said, don't ever allow the enemy of the world to take the salt from you. That's your season of your righteousness. So, but if the salt have lost his savior, wherewith shall it be salted? It is thenceforth good for nothing. So the Lord said, always keep the salt. Don't let the world and the enemy take away your righteousness. It says, but to be cast out and to be trodden under foot of men. So that's what the enemy wants to happen. He wants you to be trodden. He wants to trample you over you. And ye are the light of the world. So the Lord said, remain the light of the world. As long as we're the light, we shine light in the earth. The whole world can't be dark. God is not going to allow that. So, and to give the light unto all that are in ours. So those that are walking in darkness, you'll be the light for those that are in darkness. And they will gravitate towards you. And I said, think not that I am come to destroy the law or the prophets. I am not come to destroy, but to fulfill. For verily I say unto you, till heaven and earth pass, one jot or one tittle shall no wise pass from the law, till all be fulfilled. So all these things had to come to pass, and it shall be fulfilled. It says, whosoever therefore shall break one of these least commandments, hold on 1 second. It says, one of these least commandments, and shall teach men. It says, so shall you be called least in the kingdom of heaven. So he said, if you break least of the commandments, you'll be least in the kingdom of heaven. But whosoever shall do and teach them, the same shall be called great in the kingdom of heaven. So if you do teach these commandments to the children of God, your reward in heaven will be great. For I say unto you that except your righteousness shall exceed the righteousness of the scribes and the Pharisees, ye shall in no case enter into the kingdom of heaven. So of course, like the Pharisees and the Sadducees, they were used by the devil, and Jesus called them the children of Satan, of disobedience, because he wanted to murder him. He said they were descendants of Abraham, but you're not. You want to murder him, so therefore you're not even like Abraham. You're totally different. You're separate. You're the total opposite of Abraham. So with that being said, let's get into these prayers, these scriptures, guys. So let's go to the book of 138. So, you know, as long as you're not interceding on behalf of our nation, of our communities, of our families, the Sadducees, just like the Sadducees and the Pharisees were used by evil, the more that the people in our communities, cities, our church members are going to end up being used by evil, or they're going to be manipulated to do evil. So evil is this, when you know, as far as watching pornography or, you know, being a gossiper, that's evil. That's unrighteous in God's eyes. So we have to be the mouthpiece, and we have to be instruments and mouthpiece for those who may be in darkness. You know, when we pray, things happen in the physical, but it happens in the spiritual first. So as long as we're praying, you know, the enemy, Satan, and his minions will not be able to carry out their wicked device as they want to. So let's go to Psalms 138. Psalms 138, verse 7. And before I start, I want to definitely welcome the Lord in faith, because we need you to take control. Speak to me, Lord. All right, so Heavenly Father, we come before you. I just want to say thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Yahweh, for your grace and mercy that you show us as a nation, as a people, Lord God. Thank you, Father God, for keeping us. Thank you, Father God, for restoring us and reviving us when we are weak. Thank you for redeeming us when we are in the pits. Father God, for you are the God that delivers us out of the miry clay, out of the pit. Father God, for you are the calm. According to Psalm 91, you are a refuge and our fortress from the enemy, from invisible powers, from the unknown. So we ask you to see to it that you continue to God, protect, and continue to continuously heal us when the enemy may try to exact upon us with sickness or any type of disease. As the world continues to grow darker, for you said it is written, it will grow darker. Lord, keep us as the light, Lord God. Surround us with your light. Surround us with your precious blood. Surround us with your angels. Be a hedge of protection, Lord God. Just the same way you were a hedge of protection for Job against Satan, how he couldn't, you know, fully take control of Job. He couldn't take control of Job like he can take control of other people. For you didn't. You gave him grace. You showed him, like, super grace. So, Lord God, may you show us super grace, Father God, to not be used and overcome by the enemy. Protect our mind, body, soul, and spirit. We plead the blood on our body, soul, and spirit. We soak our families. We soak going in and going out with the precious blood. Although we soak every encounter with any people in any place that we walk to, Lord, let it be blessed. We declare and decree our going in and going out is preserved. We declare and decree our family members going in and going out are preserved. We come against any power, any force, any demon that may want to use them against us, use them against themselves, or use them to destroy any other person, Lord God. We come against it right now with the blood of Jesus Christ, with the fire of the Holy Ghost in Jesus' name. We declare every order of the enemy is overturned. In the name we declare overturned. It is overturned and it's overturned in the name of Jesus Christ. We speak blessings. We speak prosperity. We speak favor over myself. I declare favor on all sides. I decree favor even with man and with the Lord. We decree favor even with man and with kings. We decree favor with kings In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Speak through me, flow through me. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Let's go. So 138, Psalm 138, verse 7. And one thing I can tell you, the only way for God to really, transform you is when you separate yourself from a crowd that you are used to being around. You know, that means the people that you grew up with, even. If they are not seeking the Lord, or if God doesn't have, He knows what your future consists of. If they're not in your plans according to His will, He's going to remove them. Sometimes we might cling on to these people and we wonder why things are not going right between us and those people. Because the enemy, he's trying to make clear to you that these people they're not like you. They're not fitting to stay with you in the future, because they're going to trip you up, they're going to be a hindrance, and they're going to cause you to stumble. So, with that being said, let's go to Psalms 138, verse 7. So let's go to 6. It said, though the Lord be high, yet he hath respect unto the lowly. So that even though the Lord is high and mighty, he has respect unto the lowly in the earth. Those that are not, those that may be poor, lacking, they don't have it all. So he has respect unto the lowly, but the proud he knoweth the fall. So he resists the proud. Those that take pride in themselves, take pride in their money, their riches, and their property, like whatever the case may be, he resists them. He's like, I don't want anything to do with people of pride. And Satan is that's what he was in. He operated in pride, and that's what he wants you, me, and everyone else to be, to walk in pride. The pride comes before destruction. That's what the Lord said. Pride comes before destruction. Yeah, so pride comes before destruction. So it says the next one. It says, though I walk in the midst of trouble, thou wilt revive me. Thou shalt stretch forth thy hand against the wrath of my enemies, and thy right hand shall save me. So that's like, I have enemies. I had people at my workplace that were coming against me. It's like they ganged up on me. And the enemy, whatever demon it was on assignment against me. Now, when I first started working there, they weren't doing half of the things they were doing when I started, praying. It all happened when I started picking up the Bible and making videos, or when I just started just having a prayer life. And when I was praying in the bathroom. When I started praying in the bathroom on my breaks, that's when it all happened. So right then and there, that lets you know that when you turn to God, you get close to God, you become an enemy. You always were an enemy, but when you really turn away from, those things that's of the world, you become a target. So Satan wants to cut you off. So it's like, I believe these people, and they were Muslim, and the spirit on them, God allowed me to see the spirit on these people in the spiritual realm. And they had a spirit of like an antichrist or something. Because, God always said those that blaspheme against Jesus Christ, that's like antichrist. And they believed in Allah. So it's more than one Muslims in there. And they were different, from different nationalities. I don't know whether they were Indian, Arabian. So that manifested in them. So they came against me, and that spirit manifested in the other people as well. And they ganged up on me. So that's what I was dealing with. So those are the type of things that happens to the children of God. There's many people who have been raped, murdered, kidnapped because, they didn't pray. They didn't pray over themselves when they go outside the door. They don't plead the blood. They don't pray for their family members, whatever the case may be. That's what the enemy, he's able to exact upon you and trip you up when we don't pray. So God, that's the reason why God said always to pray without ceasing. So the scripture says, though you walk in the midst of trouble, though we are in the midst of trouble, the Lord will revive you. Thou shalt stretch forth his hand against the wrath of his enemies, and thy right hand shall save us. So there's many ways the Lord was fighting for me in that workplace. The Lord will cause your enemies to fight amongst one another. He will cause confusion. He will even release the spirit of madness on your enemies that seek you. You don't have to do anything to them. So we declare and agree, the Lord, he will revive you. Whatever is lost, whatever is wavering, whether it be your faith, whether it be your hope, your joy, whether it be your finances, we declare and decree the Lord will revive us, just like this nation, the peace of this nation. Seems like the enemy's trying to take away the peace of this nation. seems like the energy, the shift, the energy, the dimension in this nation, you can feel it. And it seems like the enemy is really trying to take away the peace. So we declare and decree a divine atmosphere shift. We decree and declare a divine divine shift in this nation. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, by your Spirit, Lord God, we ask you to see that you shift the atmosphere in this nation, Lord. Shift whatever is whatever order the enemy has pushed or has intruded, whatever demonic intrusion, Lord, let it be pushed out. We push it out by the blood of Jesus Christ, and let it be scattered by fire, by force, in the name of Jesus. So the Lord, what he said, will shake against the wrath of your enemies, and the right hand shall save you. The Lord will perfect which concerneth me. Thy mercy, O Lord, endure forever. Forsake not thy works to thy own hand. So with that being said, we go to Psalms 48. Go to Psalms 48. Let's do Psalms 48, 14. So this is disappointing. This is what the Lord, this is what God is going to do, you know, because of lack of obedience, because a man, you know, is being wicked. This is one. It says this, come behold the works of the Lord, what desolation he hath made in the earth. So the Lord is going to make desolations. He's going to cause things to become desolate. He's going to, you know, stop rain from pouring down. He's going to curse the food. He's going to curse the animals. And that's in Deuteronomy 28. And it says, he maketh the waters to cease. So this is one of the things that he will do on behalf of the church. He said he makes waters to cease. That means he makes waters to stop. He breaketh in unto the end of the earth. He breaketh the bow and cutteth the spear asunder. He burneth the chariot in the fire. So the chariot, he burns down the chariot to the mighty men in his world. He will burn the chariot. And he cutteth the spears asunder. So their weapons, the weaponry of man, he will break it. Said, and the Lord said, be still, know that I am God, I will be exalted among the heathen. So we declare and decree the Lord will be exalted among the heathen and in the earth. The Lord of hosts is with us, the God of Jacob is our refuge. So the Lord is a refuge for his children, whether you know it or not. He's being your refuge right now. He's your refuge when you go to sleep at night. He's the reason why you are safe when you go to sleep. You know, so many things that happen in the nighttime that you don't know about. So let's go to Psalm 48 verse 14. It says, for God is our God forever and ever. He will be our God unto death. So when you rely on God, he will guide. He will be a God. You know, God will even make a way out of nowhere for you. So it's like when you're walking in the wrong direction, you know, to the wrong door, the Lord will like move the door for you to, it's like God is a supernatural. He's like, okay, I'm going to pull the door this way so you can walk through the door. You know, if he doesn't do that, you're going to walk into a dead end. And you're trapped, or you're gonna walk to the wrong door. You open it and you fall. So he's gonna move the door that he wants you to walk through, and it's the door to your promised land. It's the door to your breakthrough. So that's how much God loves us. So with that being said, let's pray. We got three prayers, different prayers. As a matter of fact, let's go to Romans 8. Sorry. So we declare and declare the Lord. We ask you to see what they got us. We're gonna pray according to Psalms 48. Romans 8. Romans 8. Amen. God is good. So 11 says this. But the spirit of him that raised up Jesus, the spirit of the Lord God Almighty raised up Jesus Christ, the Holy Spirit. It said from the dead, he raised up Jesus Christ from the dead, dwells in us. It said, from the dead dwell in you. He that raised up Christ from the dead shall also quicken your mortal bodies. So his spirit will quicken our mortal bodies, your mortal bodies. So he will turn our sickness into evaporation. So he won't even allow sickness to exact upon inside your body. It will quicken you from disease by the spirit that dwelleth in you. Therefore, brethren, we are debtors not to the flesh to live after the flesh. So the Lord said, we are not debtors to the flesh. We are not under the law of flesh. We're not subject to the flesh. We're not controlled by the flesh. Once you're walking in the Holy Spirit, you're not gonna be overruled and can, you know, just listen. Okay, the flesh is telling you to have sex. You're slave to your flesh when you listen to your flesh. Okay, the flesh is telling you to, you know, eat cake all day and eat sweets and chicken and shrimp and lobsters. That's not how God wants us to eat. So it's many ways that the flesh, you know, enslaves people. So we're going to continue. And it says, so we're not dead to the flesh, not to live after the flesh. For it says, for if ye live after the flesh, ye shall die. So if you live, these people that in the world that are living after the flesh, they're gonna die. The word I said, but if ye through the Spirit do mortify the deeds of the body, ye shall live. So mortify the deeds. Mortify your deeds, but through the Spirit or the Holy Spirit, it will mortify the deeds of your body. And so it will quicken you, it will renew you, it will restore you. So that's like a skin. Don't you know how your skin can dry up and get flaky and be cracked? So the Spirit of the Lord can turn that layer from being cracked and broken to new fresh skin, and the flesh will come back to life. So that's how the Spirit of the Lord is. It's like it will quicken you. It will bring you back together. Versus if you weren't in the flesh, you would deteriorate. You would deteriorate and you would break down. So it's a lot of people with, hold on. So it's a lot of people with diseases and sicknesses because of iniquities. And of course, by the way, they eat and allowing the flesh to tell them how to live. It says this, therefore, brethren, for if you live after the flesh, you should die. But if you through the Spirit do mortify the deeds, sorry. So last one, sorry. For as many as are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God. So those that are led by the Spirit are the sons of God. So you have a lot of people that's in church, and this is the truth. You have people that are, this is what I learned. You have people that are in church, but they are led by the flesh. They might be in church, but they're on and off days, every day of the week, they are led by the flesh. And that's what God wants you to not be. He wants you to be delivered from being enslaved by the Spirit. He wants you to be led by the Spirit. And the only way you can be led by the Spirit is when you abide in this word, abide in love. God said, those that abide in love, he abides in them. If you abide in me, I abide in you. So we had to stay anchored in the word. And God, and this is another way, Romans 12, 2. Do not conform to the patterns of the way of this world, but be renewed by the transformation of your mind. So if you stick to the word of God and you allow it to feed your spirit, it's ever-living waters. When you feed yourself, it's ever-living waters. It's always nourishing your spirit. And it's like a sponge. Your spirit is soaking up righteousness. And I am going to have to make another video. This video, only got 2 minutes left. It's funny how I have a new phone. And this phone, the memory on it is shorter than my old phone. It's appalling to me. So that's all I got for you guys. I'm gonna do the prayer to you guys later. And matter of fact, this is just for edification. So people that's walking in the spirit, you're gonna less likely to do these things. And I have an example for you guys. We declare that the Lord will revive us, regardless of what the state of this country is going into, despite what the world is, you know, going through or what's happening. For we don't focus on the physical. For we're not overwhelmed. We're not persuaded by what the enemy is trying to persuade us. We're not. So it says this. The Lord says, and behold, I come quickly, and my reward is with me, to give every man according as his work shall be. He said, I am Alpha. The Lord is Alpha and Omega. He's the beginning and the end, the first and the last. It's nothing too hard for the Lord. He said, blessed are they that do his commandments, that they may have right to the tree of life. So that's the main purpose, the main goal. That's the main prize, to have the right to the tree of life. That's what we want God to reward us with. It says, and that we may enter through the gates into the city. So the gates of heaven, into the great city, to New Jerusalem. For without our dogs, so these are people that God saying that won't make it. Say, for without our dogs, sorcerers, whoremongers, murderers, idolaters, and whosoever loveth those things maketh a lie. And there's another scripture that even describes that. So, I think that's all. I'm going to just do another video, guys, later. So, that's all I got for you guys. God bless you guys. I love y'all. Peace.